Hi guys, this watch is an absolutely crazy watch regarding light. So this watch is what I would almost call a light monster. Everything just reflects so crazy on this watch. And I'm so very excited to bring you this review here of this Raymond Weil watch. As you can see, the Swiss brand, independent brand Raymond Weil. And this watch is just a watch I've been eyeing for quite some time. It's a dive watch, and I've been eyeing the blue and the black version. But when I was researching this watch to find a nice offer, then I actually saw that it came with a nice blue ceramic bezel insert, very kind of greenish blue, and it also came on with a very nice silver sunburst dial. And let's just get into this watch. Yeah, and you're watching Watch On Channel. My name is Anas. So this is the packaging. It comes in, of course, an outer cardboard box, and then it comes in this kind of leather box or whatever the material is. And inside you find this yet another box. So it's almost like a Russian babushka doll. You keep on finding smaller boxes within the box. And inside you find this one. And let's see if there's a smaller box inside here. No, here is the watch. So this is the Raymond Weil Freelancer. And like I said, this comes in several different versions. This version is the one that I find the most unique of the three or four or five versions. So it comes in an all black, it comes in an all blue, and it comes in also a PVD version, as far as I can see. And this version I haven't seen before I started researching the watch. And I must say, this watch is just an absolute stunner in my opinion. So everything feels quality with this watch. And every design decision that Raymond Weil decided to do with this watch is just the right choice. So it's not very often you find a watch where every little detail is just, you chose the right path when you decided this design feature. So having a look at the watch here, you can see dive watch with a Jubilee bracelet, and as you can see here in the light, it's an absolute light monster. And let me just tell you, I'm of course inside now, but when I'm wearing this watch outside in the sun, it's absolutely crazy. And it's just a very early spring here in Copenhagen, Denmark, and I look very much forward to getting a lot more sun natural light, so because this watch is going to look absolutely stunning in the sunlight, and this will most definitely be a preferred choice for me during the summer and the spring and the summer. So if you haven't sensed it yet, I'm very excited for this watch, and I'm of course, this can only become a very positive review, as I think it's absolutely amazing. So this watch retails at just about $2,000 US, I believe, but I found this watch at just about $1,000 US on Joma's shop, and you can find it at gray market dealers and on eBay at much lower prices than the suggested retail price, MRSP price. And my suggestion is that you look at this watch as a serious contender for your next entry level quality Swiss dive watch. So as always, let's have some dimensions, and then I can continue praising this amazing Raymond Weil Freelancer dive watch. So we have a case diameter of 42.5, including the crown. We have 45 thickness, fine 12 millimeters. We have a lug width of just 22, and from lug to lug we have 50.6, so a typical dive watch in its dimensions, but on the larger side than many other watches. But it wears 42 millimeters, I would say. It doesn't wear small, this watch. It wears its size, so you can't say it wears smaller or bigger than it really is. I think it wears exactly its size. So if you have a very small wrist, if your wrist is like 6.5 inch, which is just about maybe 16 centimeters, then you should definitely you should try this watch on before you purchase it. So, and that makes it a bit harder to get it from a gray market dealer, of course. If you have a wrist size like me of 7.1 inch, which is just about 17 and a half to 18 centimeters, you will have no problems. And it is a nice size for a dive watch. So as you can see, we have this amazing silver sunburst dial here, and you can see how it plays in the light. And the most amazing thing about this style, and I have never really experienced it with any other watches I own or have tried on, whenever you are in a lighting situation where you have a bright color next to it, so if you are somewhere with a bright blue book or a blue painting or something like that, then the dial would reflect the blue color. So whenever I'm usually somewhere, often somewhere where we have a lot of red color, and the dial simply reflects the red. So wherever you are, you will get different colors and reflections. And I must say, this is one of the most accomplished and amazing sunburst dials I have ever experienced in any watch. Also, as you can see here, you get this very dark blue color on the ceramic bezel insert here, which also is a light monster, but it is the dial, and I think the dial is definitely, with together with the bracelet, the star of this watch. So very simple dial, actually, Raymond Weil, Geneva, and let me just pull out the crown, so you can see the writing down here as well. Okay, here it is. So you get automatic, 300 meters, 1,000 feet, and here down at 6 o'clock, you get Swiss made. So a very interesting thing about the design of this watch is the date window, as you can see here down at 4, between 3 and 5 o'clock, just out from 4 here. It's this very interesting way of doing the date window where you get the date yesterday, the date today, which is the date the arrow points to, and then the date tomorrow. And usually you will get a date window down here at 6 o'clock or at 3 o'clock, which is the typical way of doing date windows. And I really think it's a nice choice for Raymond Weil to do this date window this way. I think it really looks great, and it gives it a kind of a sportier look somehow. I think they, like I said in the beginning of this review, whenever they had a choice, should we go left or right, should we do this or this, they made the right decision, and that's pretty uncommon. You can always find some small flaws with different watches, and I think at the price point and what this watch is, I think you're getting no flaws whatsoever. It's absolutely amazing. I have one gripe, one flaw, or it's a minor gripe, and I'll get into that later. So that was the dial. The bezel insert here, ceramic bezel insert with a loom pip. The numbers here aren't loomed, which would be really cool if they had applied loom to the ceramic bezel insert here. But anyways, we will survive. The bezel action on this watch is absolutely amazing. Just listen. So the sound is amazing. It's a 120 click unidirectional bezel. The sound, the grip is nice with the coin edge here. I have experienced watches with better grip. It's not the best grip in the world, but still, for a desk diver, it's absolutely no problem. It's easy to grip and turn the bezel here. 120 clicks, no play whatsoever, and super, super accurate and precise. Everything aligns very nicely with this watch. Very nice quality control. So let's have a look at the dial here, the case here. So a modern style case, you don't get these very feminine curves. It's a more masculine design in my opinion. So very light brushing here, which looks absolutely great because it's a tool watch. You get a lot of lighting with the dial and the insert, and also the bracelet, as you can see here, the Jubilee bracelet. And I think it's the right choice to make it brushed on the sides here, because then you don't get the crazy reflection and light as much as you get with the other parts of this watch. So on the upside here, very simple but very efficient and very well made case, I would say. So a signed crown, which is very easy to grip, very nice knurling, so it's very easy to grip, it's very easy to operate. The case back here, some people I have heard think that this case back is a bit too boring. So they are a bit like Rolex in the regard that on the Rolex Submariner, you get this completely plain case back. So you get all the information, you get the reference number here, sapphire crystal, water resistance, all the different details, stainless steel, Swiss made, and so on and so forth. But you could argue it's a bit of a boring case back. They could actually just, if they had applied the Raymond Weil logo to the case back, would have looked great, or maybe some kind of sea creature. But it's actually, I don't mind it. I think it, there's so many other great details on this watch that I don't really mind the more basic case back. So the bracelet is a big, big star of this watch. So a Jubilee bracelet, super nicely done, super, super high quality. Screw down pins, which makes it very, very easy to adjust the bracelet. No hollow end links. This is fully filled stainless steel end links. And the quality is absolutely amazing. I think you have to go up into Rolex level to find a Jubilee bracelet or a bracelet anyway. Anyways, at the same quality as this bracelet is absolutely amazing. It's so comfortable to wear. It looks absolutely amazing. And it's such a great choice. Instead of just doing the typical Oyster style bracelet, they actually went with a Jubilee, which makes this watch even more of a standout piece and a watch that you're going to notice. And as I said, you can just look at the light here on the bracelet. It's absolutely amazing. So I decided for this review to have very heavy lighting. And that is just actually to show you how crazy this watch reflects in the light. So very easy click down action here. You can see the diver's extension here. So you get a diver's extension. And then you can just put it in here. Very easy. Well-made metal parts here. Very nice buckle here with a push button function and the Raymond Weil logo here. So what is a bit of a question for me is which movement is inside of this watch. So what I know of is I believe that it's the Sellita SW200 movement, but it could be a ETA 2824 as well. So I know Raymond Weil have made watches with both types of movements, but anyways, they're basically the same movement. This is a very accurate watch. I have no question marks. I believe it's 7 or 8 seconds fast, which is perfectly fine for a watch at this price range. And as you can see here, it's as much a desk diver, a dress watch in some regard, as it is actually a dive watch. But it will be able to dive and withstand any water, and of course it's water resistant up to 300 meters, 1,000 feet. So just look at this watch. Absolutely amazing. So if you have a bigger wrist size, I believe a wrist size of over 8 inches should easily fit this watch. You can see how many parts of the bracelet I removed. So I think you should have absolutely no trouble with that. This is just a basic hang tag made in plastic. Nothing too fancy. I think everything with the packaging and stuff like that is fine, but the whole part of this is actually the watch, and this is just such an amazing piece. I will never part with this watch. I know I had the right feeling the second I saw this watch, and every time I put it on, every time I look at this watch, I know I have the right feeling. So, well, here you have the manual, simple in a lot of languages, so nothing too out of the ordinary there. So this is how it looks on my 7.1 inch wrist, 17.5 to 18 centimeters. And it looks and fits amazing. So you can see it hugs the wrist. It's a dive watch. It's not the thinnest watch, but it's definitely not a very thick watch either. It's every dimension with this watch is very nicely done. So let me just take it off my wrist again so you can have some more close-up pictures of this watch. So the bracelet feels absolutely quality. As I said just before, it looks and it feels amazing. It tapers down, which is a very nice choice, which is a nice choice to make it feel a little less massive on the wrist, which is just a very nice choice in my opinion. Also, the loom is very good on this watch. It's not Seiko loom, it's not Rolex loom. It's good loom, but it's not the most amazing loom I have ever seen. I would say any of my Seiko dive watches, my Omega Seamaster and my Rolex Submariner, has better loom than this, but it's perfectly acceptable loom. As you can see, you have all the loom markings, loom applied in the hour markings, and you have loom on the hands. And I really like these kind of maybe they could be called baton hands. I think it's a nice choice. They didn't go with any of the usual suspects regarding hands you see. So I don't really usually I end my videos with pluses and minuses. I only have one minus with this watch. It's not a big thing, but it's actually the fact that you're not able to micro adjust the bracelet. So you can only remove links. You don't have the choice of glide lock or just 1 or 2 millimeters millimeter increments here. You actually have to live with the size. So luckily enough, I removed an even number of links, and the watch fits my wrist size very well. But if you have a wrist and it doesn't fit precisely, and you remove one link and it's too tight, you put on the link, it's too loose, then you have a problem because you don't have any micro adjustments. And that is my biggest and probably also almost only complaint with this watch. You don't have micro adjustments, and that is just a very important part of a dive watch and any bracelet watch, in my opinion. You need to be able to micro adjust it. That's like the one minus with this watch. Everything else is just amazing, and I really love this watch. I can't recommend this watch enough. And if you're more conservative, you can get the black or the blue, a very nice watch. And as you know, I have a lot of, just see the light here, I have a lot of different dive watches, and I have tried tons of dive watches, but this is simply the star. So a star watch for me, a perfect addition to my collection. I will probably never ever part with this watch. I think it's such a fun watch, it's such a different watch, it's such a special watch, and I just want to applaud Raymond Weil of doing such a great watch. And I bought this watch, I'm in no way sponsored. This is just my feeling and my honest opinion, being a watch nerd, about this watch. So it all comes down to design and size and stuff like that. Do you like this watch? Do you think it's a little too plain? Do you think it's a little too much with all the blingy blingy shiny stuff with this watch? It's all down to that. It's also, if you are actually going to use this watch diving, you will probably prefer to have crown guards so you don't damage the crown. So the crown action, as I showed you before, is very nice. It just pops out all the way out. You can set the time, first position, you can set the date, which is very easy. Also, the winding is not buttery smooth, but very close to it. And I like the sound. I like the nice sound when I wind the watch. So a nice crown and a nice build of the watch, I would say. So here at the end, let me just show you a loom shot. Here we have the nice green loom. It's Swiss Super Luminova applied by Raymond Weil to this watch. And as you can see, you have the loom in the loom pip. You have all the hour markings, and then you have a brighter green, more light bright green with the hands, which is typical of dive watches. So all in all, very nice loom. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching this review of the Raymond Weil Freelancer. You can find more information regarding the exact reference number of this watch down in the description. Remember to leave a comment down below. I really like getting comments from you guys. So what do you think about this watch? Do you have any other great experiences with other Raymond Weil watches? I don't really know the line. This is the first experience I have. Also, do you have any other cool dive watches you would like to recommend? I love trying out new watches, and it's really great when I see all you guys recommending watches to each other. So we're really helping each other out and really being nerdy about our great hobby. Also, remember to follow me on Instagram and Facebook. Read my blog. You will find all the links down below. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this review. And also remember to subscribe to get more free watch content. I have a lot of content coming. So thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye. We'll be right back.
the top of 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 the top of